Jimmy Butler is back, or I should be calling him Playoff Jimmy is back, and he's better than ever. He's getting a lot of praise from former NBA players and now analysts, as well as tearing up the entire NBA, especially post-All-Star break. We'll break down his recent performances, as well as the quotes from these NBA analysts praising him and the Miami Heat on this episode of Heat Digest, where we create daily Miami Heat content. So if that interests you, subscribe to the channel, as 87% of you guys currently watching are not currently subscribed. We appreciate all your support. Now let's get to it and break down Jimmy Butler, or we should call him Himmy from now on, because he's back and he's doing what he normally does post All-Star break, and he looks really, really good. And it's great to see as a Miami Heat fan, as we know deep down, yes, Bam Adebayo is a hell of a player. He can take us a long way, but Jimmy Butler, and as far as Jimmy Butler will take us, is as far as the Miami Heat will really go, due to the fact that he's simply unstoppable whenever whenever he seems to turn it on. And when he turns it on, he just can get buckets and bunches. It seems like there's no way to really stop him. And if you try to stop him, he's just going to end up at the free throw line. He's going to shoot 10 to 15 free throws a game, and he's not going to miss that many of them. And it's great to watch as Jimmy Butler, he simply just is taking over games, and he looks fantastic. Now, it's nothing surprising, as last year he did roughly the same thing. This year, it looks a lot like last year. Last year, before the All-Star break, he was averaging roughly 21 points per game. After the All-Star break, he's averaging 25. That was last year. This year, a carbon copy. Before the All-Star break, he was averaging 21 points per game. Post-All-Star break, he's averaging 25 points per game. He's playing simply fantastic basketball. Over his last five games, he's averaging 25.8 points per game, 6.5 assists, and 6 rebounds per game. This is in the five games post All-Star break. Jimmy Butler's getting it done. He had a fantastic game March 2nd, just 6 days ago, against the Utah Jazz, where the Miami Heat did win. It was one of the only two home games we did have at home after the four-game road stand, and now going back on the road against Dallas and then against Oklahoma City. That game, he had 37 points. He shot 68%. He shot 12 of 19 from the field, and one of his only seven misses he had, he blew a layup, a fast break layup. It was hilarious to see. He ended up posting it on his Instagram story. If you guys don't follow him there, it was a hell of a clip. He literally wide open layup, put it up on the right side, right-handed layup, and he just hit the backboard, missed all of the rim. It was like a freshman type of play, a freshman in high school type of play. Funny to watch, hell of a player, and for him to miss it, it seems like everyone is human. But again, when he's on these runs, he does not seem human. Here's from Kendrick Perkins. He said this on NBA on ESPN. The top five players he does not want to run into in the playoffs, simply because they just cause way too many problems. One being Nikola Jokic, two being LeBron James, three being Steph Curry, four being Kawhi Leonard, and five being none other than the Miami Heat's own Jimmy Butler. Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if he was much higher on this list. I'd see him higher than LeBron. I know LeBron, it seems like it's inevitable. Every time you play him in a playoff series, he's going to give you a hell of a bunch of problems. But with the team in LA that they currently have, I honestly would fear Jimmy Butler a hell of a lot more than people like Kawhi Leonard or even LeBron James, due to the fact that it all starts with Jimmy Butler. It really does. It all starts with Jimmy Butler. Right now, here are his stats currently for throughout the whole season. 22 points, 5.5 rebounds, and 4.5 assists. But here are his stats over the last 12 games. Obviously, only five of them have been post-All-Star break. But again, if this doesn't ring a bell to you, these are our last 12 games. We have three losses in these last 12 games, all coming to high-tier teams, including the Clippers, the Boston Celtics, and obviously the former NBA champions, the Denver Nuggets. All three of these losses to, again, really good teams in very, very, very competitive games for the Miami Heat against these top-tier teams. And then the rest of these games are wins. Obviously, 9 of the last 12 have been wins. Great to watch. But again, it's because of Jimmy Butler really leading the way. Obviously, we've had great help with Jimmy Butler. He's averaging 25 points, 7 boards, 6 assists, 2 steals a game, while shooting 56% from the field and 53% from the three-point line. He's had one made three in the last 15 games, or 14 games, excuse me, for the Miami Heat. And he really is leading the way. These assist numbers really don't do what it really feels like he's doing. It's not giving the really respect that it feels like Jimmy Butler is really providing on the floor, due to the fact that everything starts with Jimmy. When Jimmy touches the ball on the offensive end of the floor for the Miami Heat, he attracts more than just two pairs of eyes. It seems like everyone's turning their body posture to make sure they can see the ball and then trail their man. Because of that, it's allowing him to not only manipulate the entire defense and really get to where he wants to go, but when he gets to where he wants to go, he's able to set up other players like Duncan Robinson, who has been outstanding, who we'll get to in just a minute or maybe in the next video because he deserves one of his own due to the fact that since going Tyler Hero going down and Duncan Robinson getting the starting position, he has been fantastic, and it's been a lot of the credit should go to Jimmy Butler due to the fact that he's able to touch the ball so much, and when he does, he is able to spread the ball so effectively and find players like Bam Adebayo, Duncan Robinson, and people like Jaime Jaquez, and even Terry Rozier, who's finally coming into a real role with the Miami Heat, and the Miami Heat are excelling. Like we see here, we've only lost three games in our last 12, only losing to these three, basically the three of the top teams in the entire National Basketball Association. I don't think Jimmy's going to get enough credit down the stretch of this NBA season because the Miami Heat are probably going to slip in to like the fifth or maybe in the fourth seed if we can really string some wins together here in the Eastern Conference, and we'll get into the playoffs and we'll get some credit. No one will be close to the Celtics, so the Celtics will run away with the best season or the best record of the NBA season, or at least for in the Eastern Conference. But again, we have to give credit where it is due. Yes, Bam Adebayo and the entire Miami Heat team has been fantastic all year long, battling with injuries, battling with the different lineup constructions, and everything we've really had to deal with, suspensions, fights, and everything else. But again, Jimmy Butler, when he's on the floor, especially post-All-Star break, he is looking extremely, extremely important to the Miami Heat, as obviously he is day in and day out. But again, last 12 games, especially these last five, 25, basically 26 points per game, 6.5 assists, and 6 rebounds, really dominating the ball. I don't have his usage rate in front of me, but it is extremely high, while maintaining the ability to facilitate. It's not just the fact that he's touching the ball, and it's like the Luka Doncic effect. He gets the ball, and we're looking to score. It's these long, dribbled-out possessions that where the ball doesn't really move much, and it's really stagnant offense. The ball gets to Jimmy's hands, and it's either he's going to get a basket, he's going to get fouled, go to the free throw line, where I trust him at the free throw line 90% of the time, because he does have some lapses where he does miss some free throws, and I want to pull my hair out. But also, if that's not the end result, he's making the correct pass, he's moving the ball effectively, and he's setting up other players and keeping them in the basketball game. It's not like people are getting lulled to sleep, I'm not talking about the defender in front of Jimmy, but other teammates of Jimmy Butler on the Miami Heat team aren't falling asleep on the offensive end, because they're always a threat to get the ball, because when Jimmy has the ball, he knows he's going to demand a double team, if it's not two players coming towards him, it's five players all looking towards Jimmy Butler, making sure they can see the ball due to the fact that he is such a dangerous threat with or without the basketball, as well as everyone else on the Miami Heat due to the ability to move, a lot of down screens, a lot of elevator screens, and a lot of moving without the basketball. It seems like it's a winning formula. I can't wait to see how it plays out for the rest of this Miami Heat season. Hopefully we can get to that fourth seed, the fourth seed is probably the highest we're going to be able to do, barring a big slip by the Cleveland Cavaliers or the Milwaukee Bucks. But that's to be seen. I can't wait to see you guys on the next video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys on the next one.